Today we are going to start our fifth chapter, that is bones and muscles. Each day we perform many activities. We run, we walk, we study, we play, we eat, and we exercise or jump ropes sometimes, and many other activities. Do you know our bones and muscles play a very important role in performing all these activities? Bones and muscles are the important parts of our body which make all our bodily movements possible. Come, let us know more about these in this lesson. Okay, so these are the muscles that are just under our skin, and then under our muscles we have our bones. These are bones. So, as we all know that human body has definite shape or certain shape and size. It is made up of bones and muscles covered by the skin. Okay, so if you will, as you can see here my hand, if you will press this part of your hand, you will feel softness, but if you will press or touch this part, you will feel hardness, right? So the hard part of your body are the bones and the soft part of your body are the muscles. And muscles are attached to the bones and help us to move our body parts. Bones and muscles give shape and support to our body. As if we don't have muscles and bones, we will not be able to stand, sit or do anything properly. So let us know about them in detail. The first one is the skeleton. So the bones in human body form a framework. So this is called a skeleton. That is a framework that is called a skeleton. That means all the bones together, they are, look here, there are different kinds of bones, and they are joined. They have joined here. They are attached to each other and form a framework that is called skeleton. So let us know what are the functions of skeletons or bones. Skeletons lies just below our muscles. First we have this skin, and under our skin we are having our muscles, and under our muscles are our bones. So without a skeleton or bones, we cannot stand. The number of bones in an adult human body is around 206, and the number of bones in babies are around 270. Okay, so they give shape to our body. Bones support and protect the soft inner parts of the human body, like the skull. Skull support the brain, as brain is very sensitive. The skull is the hard part of our body, so it protects the brain. These ribs protect our lungs, heart and all the organs that is made up of muscles and that are inside this rib cage. So now we will learn about joints. So the places in our body where two bones are joined are called joints. For example, we are having joint here. As you can see, I can bend my finger like this. So I am having, or we are having joint here, all the body parts that you know can bend are having joints there. We can bend our body around the joints. Joints and muscles help us in moving our body. So some of the joints are neck joint, elbow joint, ankle joint, hip joint, knee joint, wrist joint. Joints make our body flexible and help us in moving our body. Then comes the muscles. These are muscles. Muscles helps the bones to move. Okay, muscles are attached to the bones. There are more than 600 muscles in our body. Bones and muscles work together. They help us to walk, run and swim. So if you put your right hand on your left upper arm, stretch the arm, left arm, and then bend it, you will be able to feel the muscles that made the arm bend. So up till now we have learned about bones, skeleton, joint, muscles. So our body is covered with skin, And bones are the hard part of our body that gives shape and support to our body. Bones along with the muscles help our body part to help our body to move with the flexibility. All the bones make a framework or form a framework that is called skeleton. So, and joints are where two bones meet or join is called joints or are called joints. So now we will study about how we can keep our bones and muscles or our body strong. So exercise is the most important thing to do regularly to keep ourselves healthy and strong. When we use our muscles regularly or when we exercise daily, like running, walking, jogging, walking does not come in exercise. When we use our muscles regularly, they become strong. Thus, we should regularly exercise, like running. We should involve ourselves in playing outdoor games such as playing football, basketball, or just simply running and catching each other. These kind of exercises, these kind of plays involve exercising of our muscles and bones. That will keep our bones and muscles strong. And strong bones and muscles are needed to move, walk and play. Regular exercise and healthy food keep the bones and muscles strong. So exercise is an important factor to keep ourselves healthy and strong. But with exercise, we should also look after our food. We should always take healthy food, as we all know that milk provides us calcium. So we should drink regularly at least one mug of milk to keep our bones healthy, as the milk provides us calcium, and calcium is good for our bones. It will keep our bone healthy. So we should drink milk regularly. We should eat nutritious food and drink milk daily to keep our bones strong. Now comes the posture. Posture is the position, any position in which we may sit or stand or walk. So there is a particular correct posture, or we can say wrong posture of doing such things, that will give proper shape to our body. Let us know about it. The correct posture of sitting is how you should sit. If you are sitting on a chair, you should keep your back straight, keep your chest up, do not bend your shoulders like this. There should be a 90 degree angle here and 90 degree angle here, right? You should not sit in this way. And the correct standing posture is keep your back straight, keep your chest out and chin in, not like this. Your straight, the correct posture is this while standing. And the correct posture while walking is walk with your back straight. Your back should be straight always while walking. Keep your head up, your head should be up. Swing your arms freely and wear proper shoes or footwear, not like this. You should always walk like this. So these are the things that you should keep in mind while sitting, standing or walking, as a good posture, or the posture or the way you sit or stand or walk plays a very important role. If your posture is not good, you will develop postural deformities, and that will make you feel unhealthy.